In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to do the exercise at the beginning of chapter 4. Now, this exercise comes up right after you've learned how to do different types of coordinates. We've talked about absolute coordinates, polar coordinates, relative coordinates, and direct entry. And so as I'm doing this project, I'll walk you through how to do each one of those. This project has a little bit of everything in it. So we'll go ahead and get started. I'm going to go back and forth between this sketch, which you see in your book. You can follow along with the directions in your book. It's got all the dimensions for everything that we need to do on this entire project. And I'll go back and forth between that and AutoCAD. So I'm here in AutoCAD. I've got a blank drawing set up. I have not created any layers. I'm on the home ribbon is where I'm going to be mostly staying. We're going to use layer 0. And we'll get started. The book tells us to start at absolute coordinate 2, 2. So again, remember absolute coordinates come from 0, 0, wherever that might be. You can tell where your 0, 0 is. If you see it on your screen, you can tell where it is. We've got this UCS in the corner. That's your user coordinate system. And we've got a green line for the x-axis, a red line for the green line for the y-axis and a red line for the x-axis. And where they come together, that is your 0, 0. That is your origin. So as we're drawing this, we are going to click on the line command, and it's up here on the, we're on the home ribbon, the draw panel, line command. And it tells us, it wants to know where our first start point is. So where do we start this? We're gonna type in 2, 2. Press enter, and it goes right down to 2, 2. What I would recommend doing as you go through this project, at least in the beginning, when we're drawing perfectly horizontal and vertical lines, I would recommend turning on what's called your ortho option. And your ortho is this icon right here. It looks like a right angle. If you click on that, you can also type F8 on your keyboard. F8 turns ortho on and off. And you can do that in the middle of a command. Like at any point when you're drawing, you can always press F8 to turn your ortho on. But what it does is it locks me into a perfectly vertical and perfectly horizontal line here. So I'm also going to, you'll see me do this a lot. I'm going to, on my mouse, I'm going to roll the IntelliWheel up, the little wheelie ball that's in the middle between your left and right mouse. If I roll it up, I zoom in. If I roll it out, I zoom out, or I'm sorry, up zooms in, down zooms out. You can also press and hold that IntelliMouse wheel, and that does what's called pan. So you will see me do this a lot on this project, and with pan, you're just kind of moving how it's centered on your page. So I might zoom in, might zoom out. I would really recommend when you're doing this, zoom in. It's very hard to do this project if you're so far out you really can't see the lines that you're creating. So I would recommend zooming in. You can also turn off your grid if you would like. This background grid, F7 will do it, or you can click on this button to turn off that grid. I like to turn the grid off. You'll see as I do, as you watch me do drawings, I always turn that grid off. So I have definitely started at 2, 2. I'm gonna press escape right now just to start that command over again so that it's fresh. The line command, it wants to know where I want to start that command, 2, 2, enter, and that starts the line at 2, 2. Now I'm going to pull it to the right, and I'm going to type in my dimensions, so 0.50, enter. I'm going to pull my mouse up. I'm going to zoom in and pan in so I can see it a little bit better here. I'm going to move my mouse in the up direction, anywhere up, and I'm going to type in the next dimension, 0.875, enter. I'm going to now pull my mouse. I'm just pulling my mouse in the direction that I want to go, and I'm typing in the distance. That is direct entry. That is the main way that we do lines and draw in AutoCAD. So I'll pull it out this way. I'll type in 0.75, enter, pull it down. I've got another 0.875, enter. Pull it off to the right, 0.375, enter. Pull it up, 0.625, enter. Pull it to the right, 1.50, enter. Pull it down again, 0.625, enter. Pull it to the right, 1.375, enter. Pull it up, 0.50, enter. And now we have an angled line. So when we get to this angled line, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn off my ortho, just so it's, you can still do it with your ortho on, but it just makes it easier to turn it off. So I'm gonna hit F8 on my keyboard. And that takes me so that I'm not locked into that vertical and horizontal. Now, one thing that we need to talk about is, I know that it tells me in the book, it's a 0.75 length and it's an angle of 35 degrees. So anytime I know I've got an angle, this is gonna be a polar coordinate. But one thing that happens with the polar coordinates is you have to think about your starting point. If you imagine that starting point as the horizon, a horizontal line straight from where that starting point is, that's the horizon. If you need your angle to go up above that horizon, you need to move your mouse in the up direction. If you're about to do this and you keep your mouse somewhere down here below the horizon, notice that angle. It's telling me it's 21 degrees, 26 degrees. It's going to take your angle and it's going to bring it in the down direction. So we want to stay above that horizon because we want our line to go up. And now we can type in the distance, 0.75. Instead of typing comma like we would if it was an absolute coordinate, we're going to press tab. And now it's locked into being 0.75. Now it wants to know the angle. So we're going to say 35, enter. So for that polar coordinate, I typed in 0.75, tab, 35, enter. Now we've got another angle here. This one's a little tricky though. We have to do some calculating. We have to figure out what this angle is because in AutoCAD, we use the Cartesian coordinate system and our angle starts at zero. Zero is due east. This angle that we're given in the book is 35 degrees, but it's coming from due west. So it's coming from what is 180 degrees minus 35. So we have to do a little bit of math here. We got to calculate what is 180 minus 35. And we know the length is 0.75. So I will type in 0.75. And again, I'm keeping my mouse above that horizon. So my length is 0.75. Tab, and then my angle, I'm going to type it in. So we subtracted 35 degrees from 180, so that would be 145, enter. Now I have a perfectly vertical line. I'm going to go ahead and press F8 again to turn on my ortho, and I'm going to type in the distance, 1.50, enter. Now I've got another angled line, so I'll press F8 to turn off my ortho again so I can kind of move my mouse in the direction I want to go. And I know that the distance is 1. I'll press tab to get to my angle. My angle is 135 degrees. Now I'll press enter, and I just drew it. Back to my ortho. So F8 turns that ortho on. It's just nice to do. It locks you into those straight lines. Makes it foolproof. All right, so we're going to do a vertical line. I've moved my mouse just in the up direction, and I'll type in the distance of 1. Oops, no, I don't move it up yet. I actually am going to have a horizontal line here. I almost missed that. My goodness. 0.50 to the left. Now I can move it up a distance of 1. Enter. Pull it to the left, 1.25, enter. Pull it down, 0.50, enter. Pull it to the left, 1, enter. We're going to pull it up, 0.5 again, enter. And now we're at the top. It's funny. I don't think I've mentioned this. When I look at this project, it reminds me of a pig when it's completed. We'll see if you think it looks like a pig. I think it looks like a pig, like a little Picasso pig. He's kind of boxy, but he's like a Picasso pig. It's funny because Doug Smith, the other author of this book, he thinks it looks like a dinosaur, so we call it the dino pig. But this that we've drawn over here was the pig's tail, or the dino pig's tail. And now we're up at the top, which is his ear, is what I the way that I see it. So now that we've gotten all the straight lines that we can, we've got another angle. But if you notice in the book, I'll come back over here to this. We're right up here on the dino pig's ear, the top of his ear. It's about to slope down, but this time we don't have an angle. We are given a value along the x-axis and a value along the y-axis. But remember, when we're doing those values, if we start here and we're drawing it along the x-axis and we're going left, it's a negative x value. If we're going down, it's a negative y value. So when we get ready to type this, we're going to type a relative coordinate. So relative to this point, we're going to type relative, which we'll type in the at symbol to let AutoCAD know we're about to give it a relative coordinate. We'll type in at negative 0.625, comma negative 0.25. So we'll come back over here and I'm going to type. You could turn off your ortho if you wanted to, just to visually kind of get it where you need it. But I'm going to type at symbol negative 0.625, so we're going to the left on the x-axis, comma, negative 0.25, so we're going down on the y-axis. Oops. It's actually kind of good that this happened to me. I'm going to undo, and to do that, notice I have down in my command line U for undo. I can click on that word undo, or I can type U because it's the capital letter. I'm going to type in U, enter, and it undoes that last little line segment that I did. So from here, we're going to type in at negative 0.625, comma, negative 0.25. There we go. I'm not sure why it messed up. I think that it went somehow to maybe my absolute coordinate. I'm not exactly sure what I typed in there, but I'm honestly glad that that happens. You can see the best of us even have errors as we're going through it. But if you have that error, you have something like that happen in the middle of your command, you don't have to get out of the line command. You can just press U, enter, and it just undoes that last line segment for you. So this looks good. Now I've gotten as far as I can get. Let's come back and over here and look at this again. I've gotten as far as I can get. This line right here, I don't have any dimensions for it. So what I'm gonna have to do is stop. Now that we've got the little dino pig's ear, we're gonna stop there and we have to come back to this starting point. Remember, we started at 2, 2, and we're gonna work our way back, 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 and then we'll just connect the dots for this line right here. So when we come back to AutoCAD, it's still waiting for another, the line command is still waiting for another point. I'm going to press enter to end the line command. And now I'll start the line command again. And we have two options here. I can either type in 2, 2 is the starting point, and it will start directly here. Or if I hover next to it, you see that yellow box? That's called an O snap. It's an object snap, and it's going to take me directly to the exact same endpoint as that initial line. So I'll click right there using my O snap. And this time I am going to, let's just turn on my ortho again since I'm making a straight line. And I'm going to pull it in the up direction. I know that my distance is 1.20. Enter. Oh, I got another angle here, so I'm going to turn off my ortho. Notice you're going back and forth, turning this ortho on. Let's see, we have a distance of 100 and, or I'm sorry, a length of 1.50. We have an angle again, so we'll keep it above that horizon line, but this time it's still coming from 180. We're going to have to do some math again, but it's 180 minus 38 degrees. So you're going to have to do a little bit of math over here. You're going to take 180, subtract 38, and that leaves you with 142. So we will type in our length, 1.50, tab. Now we're going to type in our angle, 142 degrees, press enter. Now we have another, I'm going to take you back over here. We have another one of those. It's an angle, but we're not given the angle of it itself. We're given two different coordinates to define that point. So starting here, we need to go along the x-axis, positive 0.325. We need to go along the y-axis. We're going up, so it's a positive 0.875. So this would be a relative coordinate relative to this point where we are right here. We're going to go over on the x and up on the y and define this point. So when we come back to AutoCAD and we look at it here, we're going to type in at to let AutoCAD know that we're giving it a relative coordinate, 0.325, type in the right numbers. We'll type in comma, that lets it know we're about to give it an x and a y value, and we'll type in 0.875 for the y. Now they're both positive. That got me right here. I have one more line to draw, and that one is 0.75 in length. So 0.75, and it's at an angle of 15 degrees. So I'll press tab so that I get to my angles. 15, enter. Looks good. Now remember, this is that extra little line that we had, and we don't know the length of it. We don't know the angle of it. We just know if we drew everything else correctly, we can use our O snaps. Snap to the endpoint. Looks like a little yellow box. Click there, press enter. And you just drew a dino pig.